Hey guys, I'm Dinesh from My Geeks Blog, and I am back with another round of tips to excel your Mac experience. In my last video, I show you Mac settings to get things done quickly, and this video is dedicated to Finder app. The Finder app on the Mac is the center point for navigating through files and folders. If you set it up correctly, your day-to-day task will be much smoother. And that's exactly what I will show you today in this video. So let's get started. You may already know that by default, the Finder app doesn't show you the full path of the file or folder you have clicked. This may not be necessary for some people, but most of the users like to know where exactly their file or folder is located on their system. Here is what you have to do is open the Finder app, click on the view on the menu bar, now click on the show path bar. Now click on any file or folder and you will notice the exact path of that particular file or folder in the status bar. Moving on, next on the list is refining the search functionality in the Finder app. The Finder app on the Mac allows you to search for a specific file. But besides just basic search functions, there are many more parameters that you can set to get exactly what you are looking for. Let's check it out in detail. In the Finder app search box, type the file name first. Now click on the plus sign below that. You will notice a few drop-down menu on the left. You can define different criteria to refine your search results and find exactly what you are searching for. Most commonly used search attributes are search by file type, last opening date, last modified date, and date of creation. Besides these, you can also set the Finder app to search only in current folder. To do so, go to Finder Preferences, select Advanced, and from the drop-down list, click on the Search the current folder. You can also set to use your last scope of search criteria from the very same drop-down menu. Smart folders are basically virtual folders that collect files from anywhere on your Mac and show you in one single place. To explain, if you want all your images with JPEG extensions, you can create a smart folder with that criteria. Note that smart folders doesn't change the actual location of the file, nor does it copy or move them. To create a smart folder, first enter the search query in the Finder app. For instance, search for JPEG files. Once you see the results, click on the plus sign below the search box. Now add the criteria you wish to set in the smart folder. For example, you can set last modified options and then either specify a date or enter days. After you have achieved your desired results, click on save button on the top right side. Name your virtual folder and save it. Make sure to select add to sidebar, so next time when you open Finder app, it will be right in front of you. Not many of you will actually need this tip in your day-to-day task. That's because the hidden files are hidden for a reason. Most of the times, they are system files, which we really don't need. But if you share your Mac with someone else, you are likely to check hidden files. For that, what you have to do is open the Finder app and press Shift plus Command plus full stop. Now you can navigate to any folder and you will see the hidden files and folders slightly blurred. On pressing the same key combinations again, hidden files and folders will hide again. Now let's check out a keyboard shortcut to directly jump to a folder. In the Finder, you can navigate to common folders like Applications, Utilities, Desktop, and Home using a keyboard shortcut. This comes in pretty handy if you happen to open any of these folders frequently. You simply need to press Shift plus Command plus first letter of the folder. For example, if you wish to jump directly to application folder in the Finder, you need to press Shift plus Command plus A. Now let's take a look at how to set your favorite folder as a Finder's default folder on opening a new window. By default, the Finder app lands you on recent folder when you open a new window. We don't really save our work related to files on the system-defined folders, right? we have our own set of folders to manage and organize the file structure. Instead of navigating every time to the specific folder, it is better to set it as default. For that, what you have to do is open the Finder app, select Preferences, select General, and from the drop-down menu New Finder Windows Source, select Other. Now navigate to any folder that you wish to set as default. From now on, whenever you open a new Finder window, it will directly open with the folder you have set. As you are already in the preferences, let's make one more change that will give a better viewing in the Finder. Most of us have developed a habit of seeing folders on top and then all the files. This habit was mostly developed by Microsoft Windows. But in Finder, that's not the case. However, you do have an option to set it like that, and that exactly I will show you. What you have to do is go to Finder, select Finder Preferences, and select Advances. Now, below Keep Folders off top, there are two options. Tick the one that suits you. I have personally ticked both the options to make things seamless on my Mac. I guess you are expert by now, and so you will be using Finder in much better way. Obviously, you will have multiple Finder windows, which may have created your desktop a mess. So let's check out how to merge them in tabs. I open multiple Finder windows when I want to multitask on my file system. It makes easier to work on two windows than to navigate back and forth on the same window. But if there are more than three Finder windows, things get a little out of hand. That's when you need to know that you can merge all Finder windows into one, making your life a lot easier. First, you will need more than one Finder window. Once you have that, click on Windows from the menu bar and then click on Merge All Windows. Now you will have just one Finder window with multiple tabs. It is similar to web browser where you have multiple tabs for different websites. You may be wondering what's the need, but trust me, application is one of the folder which is always completely messed up. That's because we have so many applications installed on our Mac that becomes very tough to manage. We cannot do much about the mess, but at least we can keep the mess organized. To sort applications by category, open Finder, select Applications, and then right-click inside the Applications window. And navigate to Sort By option and then click on Kind. This will sort all your applications based on their category, making your task a lot easier. Of course, you can use the Launchpad search option, but this is just in case if you are in Finder app. Now let's take a look at how to quickly jump to the file path. Even though I'm a diehard fan of Mac, I have to admit that when it comes to jumping through different file paths, Windows has done a great job. Of course, Mac also has a similar features. It functions the same way, just the process is little different. When you are in the folder using the Finder app, you will notice the name of the folder at the center top. Right click using the mouse or single tap using two fingers on the folder. A list with file path will be displayed there. Click on the path you wish to go and you will reach there directly. If you are using column view, you may not need to use this method, but again, column view isn't always suitable. Let's say you have followed all the tips mentioned in this video and you have set up smart folders with all images on your Mac. You do get to see the image in preview when you click on it in the smart folder. But what if you wish to view it in the full screen? No, you don't need to double click it and open the image in the app. You can quickly have a full screen preview of the image by pressing Option plus Space key after selecting the image in the Finder app. It will open the image in a full screen. When you are done, just press the Escape key to go back to the Finder. That's all, friends. Let me know if I have missed any other tip for the Finder app in the comments down below. And if you find this video helpful, give it thumbs up, share it and subscribe to this channel for such handy tips. I am Dhanesh signing off and will catch you in the next one.